I'm downloading an app to help us keep score against golf. Oh, it's covered there. It looks
great. I like when you left it.
Well, then we got Mr.
J.
Wolf on the bass and the vocals. And behind you, Mr. Keenan Leader on the drums. My name is Brandon Larkin.
How interesting.
We're right now in San Francisco.
Fuck all the haters. We're in Korea. We're gonna go get some fucking Cambodian food, and then we're gonna have a foot race down the windy shit.
Oh,
and that's what's up.
Dude. I'm gonna hurt myself. Of the giant.
Don't open it.
Bro.
Don't open it. Oh god.
If it fucking splashes Whoopi, you have to buy him fucking $100 worth of casino chips.
Aaron Hooper done saved our set, didn't he, Ritty?
Aaron Hooper saved my set.
Go get him some fucking on camera pucks.
Oh, I opened up my guitar.
Tell him about this whole video.
And they're running pucks. And he's swinging on my guitar because I'm drunk.
Alright guys, here we go. We have Ritty and Brandon eating the party crabs.
I just want to know that mine is two times the size of his because I'm 2 times of a man.
Let's party.
Buy one, get one free.
Party crab time. Here we go.
Super fantastic fun time.
A deliciousness.
American French fry surfboard party crab.
Wow.
There's nothing good about this.
The texture, the flavor.
No. Oh.
It's a party.
Wow.
I don't want to cry.
I don't
ever want to know.
I couldn't do that. I would. It's
definitely not party time.
Well,
I want to like fire swallow hot sauce now.
Why don't you make a mini crab cake with it?
You guys did it. How do you feel?
It's actually not as bad as I thought it would be. The flavor is pretty like old crab.
It's worse than I thought it would be. It was crunchy for a second, and then the texture tasted like a mixture between what I imagined shit and
garbage would be like, yeah, it wasn't that bad.
Put a little bit of urine.
So you're saying it wasn't a party?
It was a party of the worst variety.
So it's like a party when the cops come and like they steal your furniture.
So that experience of like having something putrid in your mouth that like you're just, you know, so unused to has only happened to me like 2 or 3 times. That was one.
Describe those times.
One of the other ones, I was eating sushi in Japan and it was like the giant clam thing, and it was, what is it called when it's on top of the rice? But it's just like a
nigiri, yeah, nigiri.
It was that style. So we had, remember you were there?
Yeah, yeah.
And I ate that thing and it's like, I thought it would, I don't know, it just chewed for forever, and like once you bit into it, like the flavor exploded and it was like, I don't know, it was like sulfuric lava. It was horrible.
The other time was back in Cub Scouts, and you don't want to talk about it.
Yes, yes.
My taste buds are
I was an altar boy. Yeah.
All right, well, luckily you guys can wash it down with a hot dog from the wonderful hot dog machine.
I thoroughly regret my decision.
Family behind you. Wait, you gotta get in the middle. There you go. Look at that kid. Look like Darren McFadden.
Ready.
I will not do that. My Kindle is right next to him, and I don't have
here at the Book of Mormon fucking library, here with Mr. Juan Keenan.
What's up? He's y'all got your magical underpants?
He's one of the 9 brother wives over here. So is Brandon, he's the pretty brother husband.
On the 7th day, Joey Harcum descended from the heavens and said that rock and roll was not dead.
I thought that was, oh, never mind.
Whoa.
That was a clever one.
How great is his joy in the soul that repented.
Are you ready to convert to fucking Mormonology?
I've already converted. I'm ready to really practice the Mormon lifestyle.
Have you told your wife that she's going to be joined by 7 new sister wives?
I did. We're still working that part out. She's not that cool with it, but...
Pirate Rob's bringing them back in the U-Haul trailer?
Yep. I'd like to be able to pick them, but, you know, whatever.